Sac-State and Galt and San Joaquin Community College are number one. We're Hornet Family Stinger Zone!
So good evening. My name is Eugene Palazzo. I am the city manager for the city of Galt, and it pleases me to see everybody here this evening. You know, I get a lot of questions. You know, when I introduce myself as a city manager, they look at me and they say, "Well, what does a city manager do? What is that?" And you know, I look at them and I say, "Well, I'm in the business of building healthy communities." And if you think about that, building healthy communities, there's a lot of components to that. A lot of people think of police or fire, you know, our public works, where we take a look at our waste disposal or our water. But one of the key components of building a healthy community is having healthy schools. And you know, coming to this community, I've been here about 6 months, and you know, I have a great partnership with our elementary school district and our joint high school district through an organization that we call CAST. That cities and schools together. And you know, we've created these partnerships, and through that we've decided, you know, what better way to bring our community together but through education. And tonight it's kind of first time in my career where you have really your top educators in one room together that are going to speak to the community. And I think that's pretty amazing. So tonight, what I'd like to do is just walk you through our program, and I'd like to do a few introductions. Our program this evening, we'll be talking about how to prepare our children for college and careers. We will have two guest speakers this evening. They're going to be introduced by our school superintendents, Dr. Karen Schauer, superintendent of Galt Joint Union Elementary School District. We'll introduce Dr. Kathy Hart, the superintendent and president of San Joaquin Delta College. And we'll have Elizabeth Coffin, our superintendent of Galt Joint Union High School District, introduce Dr. Robert Nelson, the president of California State University, Sacramento. Once we have our presenters this evening, they'll probably be about 20 minutes apiece. We're gonna have some time for questions afterwards, and we'll see how our timing goes and how many questions. But we'd like to wrap everything up around 7:30 or so to give you time to one enjoy.
So now let's see. So I'm going to talk a little bit about, first of all, about why it's important to have education beyond high school. Some of you may be thinking, well, of course it is, or really? But here's an example of a graph that tells you one of the reasons why it's important. And that is that people are much less likely to be unemployed the more education they have. So that's one really good reason to continue education. A second reason is that higher levels of education definitely lead to higher earning. That may seem obvious also, but this graph actually shows you that without a high school education, as compared to considerable higher education, earnings are considerably higher. This graph talks more about the importance of higher education throughout the world. This is based on a survey that was given in, I believe, 44 countries, all of whom said the most important thing it was having a good education. And so, again, those are all reasons why, graphical reasons why it's important to have higher education, but there are lots of other reasons too. For one, people who have more education tend to have more job satisfaction. One of the reasons that they're more satisfied is that they tend to have health benefits and pensions at the higher levels of employment, which they have because they have higher education. They're more likely to be active citizens. They volunteer and they vote, and those are very important things. They're healthier. They're less likely to smoke. They exercise more. There's lower evidence of obesity. They engage in educational activities with their children, and this is a very important thing. We know, for example, at Delta College, that about 50% of our students are first-time college goers. And that's a lot of the reason for that is that those students' parents did not have the advantage of going to college. And so one of the things we're going to begin doing is working more closely with our parents, even at the elementary level, so that they understand what the importance of higher education is. And so they also understand what sorts of things they need to do with their kids so that their kids are more successful. Another reason for more education is in cities and the country certainly want to see this, and that is that people with more education pay more taxes and they need fewer federal support programs. Another reason is that people with more education tend to be more adaptable. They're more flexible. They're tech savvy. They're able to work in teams, and they know how to solve problems in groups, and all of those things are very important at this time in our country. We need those kinds of qualities, and those are the kinds of things people learn the more education that they have. People with more education tend to be more valuable as employees. They're more dependable, they're more accountable, they're more creative, they're more collaborative, and they're more cooperative. And those are just a few of the advantages of having more education. So what do students need to know and be able to do after grade 12 to succeed in college and career? This graphical shows you sort of an example of what kind of college and career readiness students need to have. And it's actually that little tiny section in the middle that's the intersection of the personal, the career preparation, the college preparation, and the academic preparation that all create the whole student and the really ready person either to go to college or into career. So this slide really outlines some of the areas that are more specifically outline what students need to know. So the first area is really the student's academic skills. And of course, Delta College expects these things. I'm sure that you'll hear that so does Sac State. I'm sure any college or university is hoping for students like this. But one of the things I want to point out is I'm going to talk about four areas and a kind of outline of what constitutes those four areas. But what we really want is well-rounded students who have all of these qualities and who have all of these qualities integrated. It's hard to show you what that looks like without identifying them kind of unintegrated. But what we really want is the integration of all of these skills. So this gives you an idea of some of them. Students need to have academic knowledge and skills. There's no doubt about that. They need to be able to grasp the key concepts and engage in independent critical thinking and writing and argumentation. They need to be able to read, write, do math, know something about science, know their social science. they need to have the capacity to process, retain, and apply, and I want to emphasize the word apply, content of knowledge to relevant situations. I think that's sometimes one of the things we forget is that students really need to know how to apply what they learn. Technological and digital savvy. Probably for most of you, your children have more technological skills than you do. I'm sure that's true of a lot of us. So maybe we don't have to worry that much about that one. But they also need to understand what resources are available for use and when to use those resources. They need the ability to identify, analyze, and evaluate differing and conflicting viewpoints. Those are all very important academic skills that they need. There are also non-cognitive skills that they need. And these are values and beliefs and attitudes, cultural awareness. And one of the most important ones in this category are the establishment of personal goals and some sort of life direction. If they know what they want to do, they will be much more successful than if they have no idea what they want to do. They then have some direction and can begin to shape their college or career experience in a much more conscious and intentional way. And the fourth area is really the employability and life skills. Some people call this soft skills. But in any case, it's the kinds of things that all employers want in their employees and that really the country wants in its citizens. People who are self-directed, lifelong learners, who are able to own their education and also who are accountable for what they do. And the second is the ability to adapt their communication to a specific audience or task or purpose. Those are all very important in being able to get along with others and being able to be successful both in college and in the workplace. They need time management and they need to learn collaboration and teamwork. I would say about 90% of my day, every day, is spent with groups of people discussing and working out problems and trying to reach consensus. And that isn't just the life of a community college president. That happens for everyone almost everywhere. And so learning how to collaborate, how to cooperate with others, how to negotiate with others is extremely important. And finally, civic engagement, an understanding that we're all in this together and that every one of us has obligations to participate. Those are all really important qualities that come together to prepare students to be successful either in college or career or both, because everybody who goes to college is going to end up in a career. And so I think one of the things that we've done is we've separated college from career, and I think putting those things back together is really important, because I think often students, if their college experience is one that's not applied or where they're not working toward a particular goal, seems out of context, and then suddenly they get into a job and they're befuddled because they don't really know what to do. So these four areas are all extremely important in preparing our students for college and career. Here's another graphic of what I just talked about. Much simpler, maybe, but a lot of the same qualities and learnings are represented here. And so in conclusion, what I want to say is that education beyond high school is really important, both for the individual and for our society and our society in the global environment particularly. College and career readiness are clearly not mutually exclusive. They're not two separate things, and we shouldn't think of them that way. We need to take the best of our notions of what college ready means and what career ready means and put those together, integrate them, so that if a student's college ready, he or she is also career ready, and vice versa. We also need to listen to what business and industry are saying about the kind of employees that they want, no matter what the level, because all of our students will ultimately have a job or a career, no matter how many degrees they attain. And it's business and industry who can really help us know exactly what we need to do to prepare our students.
Welcome, Galt. We're happy to be here tonight. I grew up in Montana, and I grew up poor. We lived on a little ranch, had 84 cows. We had to eat venison because we couldn't afford to eat our own beef. I have a saddle in my office to remind me of what it was like. So why do I keep that saddle in the office? I keep it there for two reasons. It reminds me that if it wasn't for an education, I should be shoeing horses right now, which was something I was pretty good at. But an education has brought me all the way to California. It took me to Illinois. It gave me opportunities. At Sac State, 49% of our students come from families making less than $38,000 a year. Yet they're going through college. IBECAS. IFONDOS FEDERALES. There are scholarships. There is the Pell Grants. College is affordable. And it can change your life. That's the first one. It reminds me who my students are. The second reason is that it reminds me that it's from the kindness of others that we succeed. We never do it on our own. The students out here, you've got great teachers. Listen to them. I didn't want to go to college. I was riding the rodeo circuit already. Not much, just off and on amateur rodeos, but I was making a little bit of money. I wanted to be a rodeo bum. Seemed like a good life to me. But I had this teacher, Mr. Sullivan. And Mr. Sullivan didn't much like me. Because we didn't have a TV, so I read every book in the library. But I wasn't going to go to college. And he wanted me to go to college. A young woman, a young student, wrote a poem. And Mr. Sullivan said to me, "What do you think of that poem?" And I was kind of a punk. I said, "Well, I think it's crap." He marched me up to the front and said, "I want you to define crap right now on this chalkboard." I started to write a bad word that starts with an H and it starts with an S and has an H in it. And I stopped because I knew I was really getting in trouble. And so I wrote detritus, which is another word for crap. He made me fill out an application. And what our president just told you about filling out that FAFSA, that's the first step. I filled out that as my punishment, an application, and because of an English teacher, I ended up in college. And I make a good living. Do you know, and this fits exactly with what you just heard, you know that if you go to college, you're not only going to make $1 million more than if you just went to high school. If you go to Sac State, and you can come to Sac State through San Joaquin Community College, okay, that's a good way to go. Or you can come straight. But if you come there, out of all of the universities in the United States, there's thousands of Sac State students have the 59th highest salaries on average in the United States. Think about that. That's that school, that Hornet school, just a little ways from here. Think about where you can end up if you go there. And our students do succeed. Oh, I'm worried about debt. I'm worried about debt. Everybody goes to college, they're in too much debt, right? 65% of our students graduate with zero debt. We help them get jobs. We help them get internships. We help them succeed. We get them the grants that they need. The 35% who do graduate with debt, it's only $20,000. That's not even a car. Yet they're going to make $1 million more because of that education. Our students can succeed. I want to tell you about a couple of them. I want to tell you about a young migrant student, Maricela. Maricela is from Houston, not Texas, Houston, California. She worked in the fields. She's undocumented. You don't think she can make it? Her dad is an alcoholic, a drug user. Her parents did not want her to go to college at all. They said, mija, tenemos que trabajar. Got it. We have to work. They wanted to work in the field with him. Well, this young woman, and I don't want you students doing what she did, but she ran away. She ran away to Sac State. And in 4 years, she graduated. And right now, she is in Indiana, chosen of one of 20 young women in the United States to go to graduate school to be a professor in speech and pathology. She did it. Anybody can do it. How many of you look at Pandora and listen to Pandora? A lot of you do, right? Okay, that's that radio station. It's on the internet. You're listening to it all the time. You hit that like button, right? Who thought of it? Kid from Elk Grove, a Sac State graduate. He's been there for 3 years, and he's already making the hundreds of thousands of dollars at Pandora. Yes, kids from Galt can make hundreds of thousands of dollars. They've got to have the math skills. And you students need to be taking math in your senior year. You cannot blow off that senior year. You got to be prepared. Use that senior year to get you to the next level, because you're going to write the next algorithm. You're going to be the next engineer. You're going to be the next farmer that knows how to raise better crops with less water, because you got that education to help you get there. You're going to be the farmer who can fight for water rights. You're going to be the engineer who can invent the next great machine. So, college readiness. Taking the classes that you need, being ready to get there. You need to take math. You need to take hard English courses, because you're going to write the rest of your life, and it never stops. And that writing is what's going to make you there and make you successful. As you move forward and prepare yourself, always dream. Dream big. That Venn diagram that was up there, that whole person that's in the middle, that person's the dreamer. Too many times we think we can't, and we don't. College isn't for everyone. It was the right thing for me. It was the right thing for Drayon. It was the right thing for Selena. So at Sac State, we are committed to graduating our students in 4 years. And we're committed, if a student comes from San Joaquin Community College with an ADT, with an associate degree for transfer, we're committed to graduating them in 2 years so that they can come forward. Now to do that, we've got to have all of the classes that they need. And this semester, we added 10,000 seats at Sac State so that every freshman got every, some of you that went, you're going to be mad because you remember rushing and crashing from courses and trying to get that course. You don't do that anymore at Sac State. We have every class you need. We added over $1 million in new professors. Next year we're adding 69 additional professors in engineering, in the STEM field, science, technology, engineering, math, but also in the arts. Now, being an English major didn't do me that bad. Although I shouldn't say that badly. Yes, it's possible. Anything's possible if you dream. Go to your counselors. Talk to them and make sure that you've got the right classes. Parents, go with them to the counselors so that you're talking together. Sit down and plan out a college plan. Talk to these people. They will help you. We will help you. Como dije, ustedes están en mi corazón. As I said, people in this valley, this area, they're in my heart, and they're in the heart.
Sac State and Galt and San Joaquin Community College are number one. We're home.